Hi there, Chris here, another quick tip for you all. In this video, we are going to continue our look at painting the Fetid Bloat Drone from the Dark Imperium box set. And as you can see, the model is nearing completion as we've already completed the armor, the flesh, and we are going to begin working on the rusty metal effects on the model. We're going to start off with some lead belcher. We're going to thin this out just really with the dampness of the brush, just to thin it out just a little bit. And basically, we are going to begin base coating the propellers. Now, the propellers caught a bit of overspray when we were working with the colored sprays earlier, but that's fine because we're simply just going to color right on top of what we had previously done. And as you can see here, it goes by fairly quickly. We're also going to give a base coat to the back kind of clamp kind of area on the, I don't guess the ammo containers, I guess, on the guns, as well as the gun barrels themselves, but not at the very ends where the muzzle brake is. We're going to color that something else later on. And so we're basically going to just do those, as well as the side vents and that big tank on the back that's kind of in that clasp of the kind of tail of whatever that is on the back. But as you can see there, it's all given a nice little coat of lead belcher. Next, we're going to come in with some Necron compound, and this is going to be a quick little dry brush, basically just to catch the edges of the surfaces. As I work my dry brush around the propellers, I'm going against the direction of which the blades are turning so that I'm catching just the raised surfaces. If I was going opposite, I'd probably end up getting more silver on the blades rather than just catching just those edges. And that's all we're looking to capture. And as we work on the vents and the little tank there at the back, I don't know what that is. Again, it's just a quick little dry brush again, just kind of really bring out the brightness on the silver. And again, on the gun, we're just simply catching all those little raised areas on the gun, as well as the ammo clasp on the back as well. Again, you can see it goes by fairly quickly, and one thing it didn't show is also the undersides of the belt of the turbine blades. They're also painted as well. Next, we're going to go with some burnt umber, and this is a dry pigment from Vallejo. This is the Vallejo pigments, and I'm using mineral spirits to fix the pigments into place. I'm using a synthetic brush to apply the pigment itself, and I'm using just a regular old sable brush to apply the mineral spirits. Basically, I'm going to use two brushes because you want to keep them separate. You don't want to mix the two because, again, you don't want mineral spirits mixing into your dry pigments. You see, I simply just begin laying a little layer down of mineral spirits, not heavy or anything like that. Just basically just kind of coat the surface and then begin stippling the pigments into place. And this is basically just to work the pigment into all the little nooks and crannies. And again, it gives you an overall tone over the rest of the model versus if we had applied it dry, it would have been a little bit different. And of course, the one thing that isn't quite shown is also that when I'm done applying the pigment to the area, I simply pull it off to the side and give it a sharp blast of air, usually just breathe on it or what have you, just to knock the excess pigment off. And again, it just dulls down the effect a bit. But of course, when we are working with pigments in this fashion, it is okay to do a little bit too much on an area, because again, you'll see later on, you really kind of want to overdo the effect sometimes just a little bit. Here again, you can see I simply lay the mineral spirits down where I'm going to apply the pigments and then begin stippling the pigments onto place. Now, you don't have to use a synthetic brush when applying the pigments. I just happen to be using a synthetic brush because it's got nice stiff bristles. But of course, if you have any other stiff brush to apply pigments in this fashion, this is only one way to apply pigments to your model. There's many ways to apply pigments. This is just the way I happen to like for this particular method here, and because I want to maintain a bit of control as to where I'm applying the pigments. Dark red ochre from Vallejo Dry Pigments as well. Of course, I always say dry because, I mean, you know, you can have some that are not quite as dry, and, you know, basically paint is a wet pigment. But with this here, it's not as quite as heavy, and I'm not laying the mineral spirits down either. I'm allowing whatever residual mineral spirits that is still kind of damp, and it dries up pretty quickly, but I'm using whatever is there just to help fix the pigment into place. And that's really what the point of the mineral spirits is to fix the pigment into place. You could also use rubbing alcohol as well if you don't have any mineral spirits. Rubbing alcohol works, or isopropyl alcohol works just as well. Again, you can see here it's just a very deliberate just dab here in the corners, and again just kind of top surfaces, and just being somewhat deliberate and random at places, just because, you know, you want to get some of those rusty effects. It looks better if it's fairly uneven. Then really quickly here, I take my brush, it's a little bit damp, and I'm just wiping the excess off just the leading edges of those blades, because I want a bit of that shine back in those blades. You could also use your fingers, but again, you know, those tight little nooks and crannies on that, it's really kind of hard to get your fingers finger in there, so you have to kind of use a brush or a damp brush, and it'll wipe the excess away. Here you can see I'm simply using my finger to wipe away on the barrels, on the clasp on the back, and then at the little exhaust vents along the side of the body, on the upper tail portion as well, and the big kind of gas tank on the back. But that is it. That is rusty metal on the Blight drone. It's as easy as that. We got even more painting tutorials in the Silver Mini Wargaming Vault. You can watch another one today about how I complete the copper effect and create a nice rusty copper effect on this model. Just sign up for a free 7-day trial. Make sure that you get the Silver membership, and you'll get instant access to over 1,000 painting tutorials already in the vault. And so thank you for watching, and happy wargaming.